Hi, this is Dr. Bob Rausch at EnergyDrivenLeader.com, where we work with only the brightest and the best. Those leaders who have a desire to grow personally, who want to develop strong teams, and also have that wonderful work-life balance. When every dollar counts, it's good to know how to get the performance you want out of those individuals through short-term coaching. Now, coaching still lets you be the leader and the manager that you are, only it helps you do it better. We've talked about 5 steps of discipline. 1, communication. 2, concern. Those are informal steps. Find out what the person knows about their job. Find out how they need to do it differently. Check back with them in a week. How's it coming? Have you done the objectives that you mentioned? And then the 3rd step is coaching. Coaching is a formal step. The 4th is consequences for getting the job done or not. And then the 5th, hopefully, is celebration. After you've gone through the first 2 steps and you move to coaching, you're moving to a formal process. Now, it doesn't have to be long. It doesn't have to be an hour long. It can be 5 to 8 meetings, 15 to 20 minute meetings with that individual, helping them set the parameters of what they want to accomplish. This is a must-do step. And it doesn't take a lot of time and it doesn't take a lot of energy, but it is a must-do step. When a person begins into the coaching process, they are either going to make it or they are not. If they still can't get the job done through coaching, then consequences. They're either in or they're out. Now, what is it that we should consider when we talk about coaching? What are those things that people would come to you and want you to coach them? Well, the first thing is when a person wants to develop a specific behavior. Those are lovely people when they come and say, look, I need to develop this in my leadership toolbox, and can you help me do that? Those are great opportunities. The second thing is when an individual's not meeting expectations, and you need to set up those coaching sessions to help them meet the objectives and find success, hopefully, in your coaching process with them. The third thing is individuals who are learning a new process or a new product, who need some short-term coaching to understand how best to utilize that process or utilize that product. And 4, individuals who need help when they're in conflict with another person. Sometimes it's good to have both people in the room, but if you're working with one person who's too aggressive, too assertive, then setting up coaching meetings for that person to help them solve that particular problem can really be helpful in terms of their career and their success. Now, if you would like all of the information that I have on the fundamentals of coaching, just send me an email to drbob@energydrivenleader.com.